So exactly what is a prototype? I was going through all the videos in this series and looking for topics that I might have missed. And it turns out that I missed one of the most important ones, and that is, what exactly is a prototype as far as an inventor is concerned? This may surprise you because it's not what you think. I imagine that most people consider a prototype something that is a proof of concept, shows you how it works, and gives you a rough idea of what the design is. But that's not the case for an inventor. As far as I'm concerned, your prototype is 99% the equivalent of the product that you're going to sell. And before you get all upset and say, well, that's not a prototype, that's going to cost me a lot more money. Not if you design it correctly. Yes, your prototype can have a few 3D printed parts and some other handmade items, but for the most part, it pretty much has to be finished. There are parts of the manufacturing process that require stamps, molds, things like that. So we know that you really can't make that first prototype complete because then the molds have to be made. So, you know, we're talking about a fully functional prototype that looks almost as identical as the one you're going to sell. The reason that I stress that it must be done this way is because this is how you work out all the kinks in manufacturing ahead of time. Now, I talked about this in previous videos that as you become more and more skilled, you'll be able to look at the design on the computer and pretty much determine if it's going to work or not and how everything fits. But I will say this, it's a good idea to at least 3D print the thing in its entirety, because I've been surprised sometimes where the scale is not what I think. In other words, maybe I'm making something that fits in the palm of your hand and I like the dimensions on the screen, but when I go and print it out, it's either bigger than I thought it was or smaller. Sometimes it's hard to really conceive what that product looks like in the real world. So this is another reason that finished final prototypes are most important. If you trust me on this and spend just a little more time, effort, and money on the prototype and making it look finished, you'll soon discover that your manufacturing process is actually cheaper, and you won't run the risk of big mistakes once you release the product. So spend as much time as you can in the design phases of your product. But when you go to prototype, do it for manufacturing. Print a few things along the way, laser cut a few things, whatever you need to do. But for the most part, that prototype should look perfect.